Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for December the 1st of 2019, well, it is titled Starburst Galaxy M94 from Hubble. So what do we see here? Well, this is an example of what is called a starburst galaxy. It's a type of active galaxy, which is a little more active and shows a burst of star formation. And in this case, we see it as a ring of material spiraling around the center of this galaxy. So this would be a spiral galaxy with spiral arms and dust lanes stretching around. But you notice that the blue stars are actually in a ring shape almost around the center. And that is an enhanced burst of star formation because it has far more in terms of blue stars than an ordinary spiral galaxy would. So here we're actually looking at just the central portions of this galaxy. And then the question can be, why did they form in a ring here and not just within the spiral arms at a slower rate as an ordinary spiral galaxy did? And there are a couple of reasons for enhanced star formation. One would be a collision between two galaxies. If galaxies collide together, their dust and gas clouds would collide and compress and begin to form new stars. So that would be one possibility, but doesn't seem to be the what is going on in this case. Actually, it seems that this one is more of a wave almost propagating outward. So some kind of disturbance at the center that may have propagated outward, and as it compresses the gas and dust, as it works its way outward through this galaxy, is then compressing it and enhancing the formation of stars. Now, we know those stars had to have formed recently because of the type of stars that exist there. They are very hot blue stars, and these stars don't live more than a few million years. So we can estimate that these stars must have formed within the last 10 million years or so. And as with typical, that may seem like a long time to us, but in terms of the lifetime of a galaxy, that is very, very short. So a galaxy like our own is about 10 billion years old, so 10 million years is only 1/1000th of the age of the galaxy. So a very, very short time, a very short part of the entire history of the galaxy. So over the age of the galaxy, this could then propagate outward and continue as these stars age and die. The compression that formed them could be moving outward through the galaxy and could form more in the outer layers. As we are looking at just the inner portion in this case, as it stated, this is Hubble's telescope looking at about 7,000 light years worth, whereas the entire galaxy would be about four times that size. So we're looking at an inner ring here that could propagate outward over along next hundreds of millions of years, continue to propagate outward through this galaxy and make it remain a starburst galaxy for a long time to come. So that was our picture of the day for December the 1st of 2019. It was titled Starburst Galaxy M94 from Hubble. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be running Mercury. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.